The jazz world and the entire music community lost one of its greatest voices when Chick Corea died earlier this week at the age of 79. Anthony Armando Corea, or Chick as he was known to most of us, was one of the giants in jazz music. He was a prolific composer, an impeccable pianist, and one of the greatest improvisers you'll ever hear. If you've visited my channel before, you know that I'm a bassist. The bass players that Chick Corea assembled over the years read like some of the greatest virtuosos to ever play the instrument. Beginning with Steve Swallow, Stanley Clark, Eddie Gomez, Bunny Brunell, John Patitucci, Avishai Cohen, Christian McBride. Chick was amazing. And our entire community is feeling his loss, as we will be for a long time. If you've been on social media at all lately, maybe you've seen this list surface. Chick gave a lecture at the Berklee College of Music in 1985. As students entered the auditorium, they were handed this type page called Cheap But Good Advice for Playing Music in a Group. 16 pieces of indispensable advice for any musician playing any instrument. In the days since his passing, people have been rediscovering it and sharing it. So I thought I would take this opportunity to share some of Chick's wisdom with you. Number one, play only what you hear. The golden rule in jazz. If you can't hear it, you can't play it. If you can hear it inside or sing it in your head, then it'll be much more powerful and truthful when it comes out on your instrument. Hear it first. Number two, if you don't hear anything, don't play anything. Right? Space. Number three, don't let your fingers and limbs just wander. Place them intentionally. Have a purpose. Have direction. Be mindful about what you do and not random. Number four, don't improvise on endlessly. Play something with intention. Develop it or not. But then end off. Take a break. Periods in between your sentences. Breaks in between your paragraphs. Make a statement. We all know how frustrating it is to read an email from someone with no break in it. Imagine musically that coming at you. Give your listener time to process what you just did. Again, space. Number five, leave space. Create space. Intentionally create places where you don't play. I love this. I tell a lot of my students that the rests are just as important as the notes. You should have negative space just like you have positive space. Number six, make your sound blend. Listen to your sound and adjust it to the rest of the band and the room. So important to play as a group, as a unit. How do you sound with the rest of the group? Make a conscious choice to blend with the group and have the group be heard over just one person's sound or volume. Number seven, if you play more than one instrument at a time, like a drum kit or multiple keyboards, make sure they are balanced with one another. Again, the balancing of sound. No one part of the band jumps out above everybody else. No one instrument should be louder or more noticeable than anyone else at any given time. Balance, blend, support. Number eight, don't make any of your music mechanically or just through patterns of habit. Create each sound, phrase, and piece with choice, deliberately. With choice. Do not make music by accident. You are in control. It's about you being deliberate about how you place things and your choices. You have choice. You have choice. Control what you do. Number nine, guide your choice of what to play by what you like, not by what someone else will think. You have to do it for yourself, not for likes, not for views, not for applause, or awards, you have to make your own conscious decisions based on what you like and what you want to sound like, and not what anybody else thinks. Number 10, use contrast and balance. The elements, high, low, fast, slow, loud, soft, tense, relaxed, dense, sparse. He says it all right there. Put positive and negative in your solo, black and white. Put soft and loud, busy and relaxed. Every kind of color you can think of. Exaggerate your gestures and put different types of space in your solo. It'll make everything a lot more interesting and varied when you tell your story. Number 11, play to make the other musicians sound good. Play things that will make the overall music sound good. Amen to this. Make the music sound good. Your goal should be to lift everyone else up around you so that the group sounds great. Focus on the group sound and everything else will fall into place. Number 12, play with a relaxed body. Always release whatever tension you create. This is something I can work on myself. That's, I bear down, I get nervous, I tense up, my breath becomes short, right? It's almost like you're gonna lift a heavy weight and you bear down before you do it. We have to be as relaxed as possible. How do you play fast? You relax. Number 13, create space. Begin, develop, and end phrases with intention. Begin your phrases with intention. End your phrases with intention. How do we start a good story? We say, once upon a time. Do that musically. Set your story up, and when it ends, we say, and they lived happily ever after. Musically. Number 14, never beat or pound your instrument. Play it easily and gracefully. The best musicians are the most relaxed musicians. We have emotion, but it has to come out musically, not physically. Some of us release ourselves physically upon an instrument. Your best playing is gonna be in a very controlled and streamlined way. I really need to follow that one. Number 15, create space, then place something in it. You dig? Make space first, then fill the space. A long time ago, I read a quote from the great bassist Charlie Hayden, who said that he always started from silence. Great music always starts from silence. You wait, you listen to the silence, then you fill the silence up. Isn't that incredible? Number 16, use mimicry sparsely. Mostly create phrases that contrast with and develop the phrases of the other players. This one happens a lot, right? Somebody starts to get into a kind of a figure and we start mimicking one another rather than complementing each other. We're different parts that come together to make something unique and whole. Your job as another member of the band and an active listener is to develop what your bandmate is saying, right? To develop what they're saying, to lead them on, to point them in a certain direction, not repeat what they're going to say. You need to encourage them musically, maybe give them a nudge every once in a while, and follow, not just mimic it. Sage advice, if I've ever heard it. I cannot understate the impact that Chicoria's music has had on my life and my own personal journey. I started playing bass when I was about 13 years old, and I was listening to a lot of progressive rock. It had a feeling about it that was exciting. It had energy. It made me feel good. I loved the rhythms and the sounds. I wasn't interested in jazz. That was the music that my mother listened to and my grandfather, and it didn't seem like I was in touch with it. Then my best friend played me the first Chick Corea electric band record, and it changed my entire life. The feelings I got from that record that was obviously jazz, walking bass, jazz rhythms, phrasing, improvisation, the feelings I got from that were as powerful, if not more strong, than any great rock music that I had ever heard before. I was touched and moved, and I had to listen to it every single day. I had to get every Chick Corea album that I could get my hands on. I had to try to play it. When I got to college, I dissected it and studied it and took it apart. And as an adult, I can tell you that it's had practically the same effect on me as it did at any time when I was a teenager. I love a lot of different kinds of music, and I'm influenced by a lot of different kinds of musicians, but I can honestly say that I've listened to his music more than anybody else during the course of my life. It helped me decide to play jazz. It helped me to want to become a great jazz musician, to study jazz harmony, to work on my jazz improvisation, to really delve deep into the music. He gave me that passion. He was that bridge. No matter what time period you point out, his music has been the most meaningful to me during the course of my life. All I can say right now is thank you, Chick Corea, for your shine, your amazing music, which has given me a passion, an inspiration. And while you're not with us anymore, I think it's appropriate to say that legends never really die. Godspeed.
I regard that all of these machines and mechanisms and instruments and things that we have and theories and any kind of mechanics, they're all servo mechanisms. They just serve the one idea, which is to create and to give that to someone. It's real simple. Art is real simple. It's a communication. And when you're feeling good and you're succeeding at it, that means you're getting it across. It's happening. You're creating, someone's getting it, and there's success and pleasure in that.